One day special midcap mania with Nigel D'Souza, and the company on his radar is the one that makes specialty chemicals, and the stock trading lower by about 50% since July this year, but before that had a big rally. Nigel?
That's right, Anuj. The stock that we're talking about is Fineotex Chemicals. As you said, it had a big rally from the period from October 2014 all the way till July 7th, 2015. It put on more than 350%, but from July 7th onwards, in fact, the stock has been under pressure. Today as well, it's higher. Even in Friday's trading session, it's higher. But otherwise, the stock is still down roughly around 45 to around 50% from July 7th, 2015 itself. Now, looking at the shareholding pattern, you get confidence when the promoters go on hiking stake. And they have been doing precisely that in the last few years. That's the promoter stake in the last few years, gone from around 62.5% all the way to around 71%. I was looking for some big institutional holders, etc. That wasn't to be, but we have a big Bachchan in there. He holds around 5.3% and he holds the stake for the last few years. Institutional activity as well, FIIs, now they have around 0.9% stake in the company from absolutely nothing approximately a year ago. So that's about the shareholding pattern. The financials as well, on the top line itself, there wasn't much growth. In fact, there was a small degrowth in the last quarter, but margin expansion is something that really has been driving the stock. So you take a look at it, the operating profit was higher by 75%. Pull up the margins as well. They, in fact, now they are at around 22.6%. That compares with the 12.8%, and profitability as well has jumped up by a good 68%. The management has given various reasons. I was going through the presentation. They say that, in fact, they have been looking at value-added products. So that's something that's really helping them. They have close to around 400 products. They have a subsidiary in Malaysia. That's helping them. And finally, they said that, in fact, they have expanded their presence in the UAE. So that as well has helped them in terms of their performance in this last quarter. So let's look at the valuations then. It did around 30 paise as an EPS for the last quarter. Annualized should be around 1.2 times. So the stock is trading at roughly around 19 to around 20 times. You take a look at the EBITDA as well. 5.7 crores is what they did. So on a yearly basis, they could have done around 22 crores. It doesn't have any debt. So market cap of around 240 crores approximately. It's trading at around 10 times EV upon EBITDA. Let's run through the positives then. The last four-year CAGR, if you look at it, on the top line, there's not much, but the EBITDA has been growing by 30%, profitability as well by roughly around 30%. So that's a positive. No debt, always a good thing. And also they have presence in quite a few countries, so 33 countries in total, manufacturing facilities both in India as well as Malaysia. And finally, small dividend paying a company, but you always like that. And what's the downside to it? There are various challenges. So foreign fluctuations, they can be hit by adverse movements in foreign currency. That's one. Second is that, in fact, sustenance of margins, that's the key. They're not seeing any top-line growth. So margin performance, that's really going to be important. Company's been functioning at around 70 to around 75% capacity utilization. The Indian textile industry takes a lot of the chemicals that are produced. So that's a real key. The Indian textile industry needs to keep growing for them to keep getting business. And finally, rising crude prices, the management has stated in one of their presentations that that could be a bit of a negative. So if you see crude spike up, then it could really hit their margins. Back to you.